Thank you. ride safe.
Jay and I are dryads. we're gonna be fine.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. We come on this very beautiful day to join in marriage, Edward and Stacey. It is our fondest hope that their separate lives may together explore new dimensions of love. In recognition of this step in the marriage, we present Stacey to be married to Edward now. Yes. This time I'd like to ask Stacey's family, you accept Edward into your family, afford him all their privileges, and if you wish your very own, if so, answer, we do.
We do.
I'd like to ask Edward's family, you accept Stacey into your family, afford her all the privileges, and if she wish your very own, if so, answer, we do.
We do.
We do.
The family and friends say you see it. Marriage is a coming together of two lives and a celebration of the love of two people. But it is much more. The love that Edward and Stacey feel for one another is a flowering of a seed their parents planted in their hearts years ago. As they embrace one another with their love, so do they embrace the families which have brought together in a special occasion. As a sign of their love for their families, Edward and Stacey would like to offer these symbols of eternal love, these roses to their mothers. These roses are a promise that no matter how far apart you are, that you are not forgotten. They are always in their hearts and in their prayers. Edward and Stacey each have a very beautiful rose, and these are memorial roses of Stacey's father, Erwin, and also the grandparents, Ephraim and Irene, and also to Edward's grandparents, Harold, Wayne, and Grace. And we know that these individuals are here spiritually, and their blessings are upon this very beautiful wedding. I would also at this time like to invite the primary sponsors to please stand, Glenn and Phelan, and Gil and Gemma, who are standing in place of Julie. Would you primary sponsors please stand? Thank you very much. This time, may we please have the presentation of the veil. This time, instead of the veil at this time, we will have the sponsors please come forward to light the candles. May we please have a presentation of the veil? And the veil is to clothe you as one. And the veil that you see from the head of the bride to the shoulder of the groom is a symbol of partnership in life, sharing and bearing each other's burden throughout the married life. Jesus said, clothe yourself in humility toward one another. And to the Christian marriage life, there is no place for pride. Christian marriage partners are humble, honest, and open toward each other. This is one of the greatest blessings of marriage. May we please have the presentation of the cord? And the cord binds you together. It is a symbol of true love that will bind you as one. And God thought of and described marriage in far more noble, intimate, and personal terms. He said, and the two shall become one. In the sight of God, and therefore in the sight of the Christian, marriage is far more a union than it is a contract. It is a blending and bonding together of two people, spiritually, emotionally, and socially, and physically. Only a union filled with Christian love can make two people become one. I would like to share with you a very beautiful thought, which is entitled Happiness. Happiness in marriage is something that just does not happen. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being told to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not expecting the husband to wear a halo or the wife to have the wings of an angel. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each one can grow, and it is finding room for things of the Spirit. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner, and it is forming a circle of love that gathers in your entire family. And Stacey, do you choose Edward to be your husband? Will you love, respect, and honor him? Always sharing your plans and interests, your ideals and your emotions, through crisis and anxiety, through joy and pleasure, always caring for him in lifelong commitment. If so, answer, I will.
I will.
And Edward, you choose Stacey to be your wife. Will you love, respect, and honor her? Always sharing your plans and interests, your ideals and your emotions, through crisis and anxiety, through joy and pleasure, always caring for her, and lifelong commitment, if so answer, I will.
I will.
Before sharing to each other your marriage vows, I would like to share with you St. Paul's very beautiful love chapter. It's found in 1 Corinthians 13. And love is patient, And love is kind and envies no one. And love is never jealous. It is not boastful. It is not conceited. It is not rude. And love is never selfish. It is not quick to take offense. And love keeps no score of wrongs. It does not gloat over other men's sins, but it always delights in the truth. There is nothing that love cannot face. There is no limit to its faith, its hope, and its endurance. Love will never come to an end. And in a word, there are three things which last forever. There's faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of them all is love. Edward, today I promise to love.
Edward, today I promise to love.
And honor you all of my life.
And honor you all of my life.
To give you my strength.
To give you my strength.
To stand by you in joy and in sorrow.
To stand by you in joy and in sorrow.
And ask you to stand by me.
And ask you to stand by me.
I want you to share your hopes.
I want you to share your hopes.
Desires and dreams with me.
Desires and dreams with me.
I pray that our home.
I pray that our home.
Will be one of love and understanding.
Will be one of love and understanding.
I promise to care for you when you are sick.
I promise to care for you when you're sick.
Stand by you when times are difficult.
Stand by you when times are difficult.
And to share the warmth and joy of life.
And to share the warmth and joy of life.
I give you all of my trust.
I give you all of my trust.
And all of my tomorrows.
And all of my tomorrows.
I will grow with you as long as I live.
I will grow with you as long as I live.
Stacey, today I give myself to you.
Stacey, today I give myself to you.
And ask for your tomorrows.
And ask for your tomorrows.
I promise to love you more than anyone else can.
I promise to love you more than anyone else can.
To give you my strength.
To give you my strength.
And ask for yours in return.
And ask for yours in return.
I want you to share your hopes.
I want you to share your hopes.
Desires and dreams with me.
Desires and dreams with me.
I promise to care for you when you are sick.
I promise to care for you when you are sick.
Stand by you when times are difficult.
Stand by you when times are difficult.
And to share the warmth and joy of life.
And to share the warmth and joy of life.
I give you all of my trust.
I give you all of my trust.
And all of my tomorrows.
And all of my tomorrows.
I will grow with you as long as I live.
I will grow with you as long as I live.
Don't grow too
just not higher.
The wedding rings serve as a symbol of the vows you have just spoken. They are the outward invisible sign of an inward invisible love which binds your hearts together. These rings are the finest of earth's materials, so your love is the richest of spiritual values. These rings are without end or seen. They have no beginning and they have no end, which symbolize the perfection of a love that cannot end. And bless these rings to be the visible sign of the vows you made, that each who gives a ring and each who wears one may ever be reminded of their promises, evermore living and growing in the spirit of love. Place the rings on your left hand. Repeat after me. Stacey, this ring I give you.
Stacey, this ring I give you.
In token of our marriage vows.
In token of our marriage vows.
May it always be a symbol.
May it always be a symbol.
Of my everlasting love for you.
Of my everlasting love for you.
Edward, I accept this ring from you.
Edward, I accept this ring from you.
And I wear it as a sign of my love for you.
And I wear it as a sign of my love for you.
Repeat after me. Edward, this ring I give you.
Edward, this ring I give you.
In token of our marriage vows.
In token of our marriage vows.
May it always be a symbol.
May it always be a symbol.
Of my everlasting love for you.
Of my everlasting love for you.
Stacey, I accept this ring from you.
Stacey, I accept this ring from you.
And I wear it as a sign of my love for you.
And I wear it as a sign of my love for you.
This time, may we please have the removal of the cord. Could we please have the removal of the veil? May we please have the presentation of the coins? The coin is a form of money and one of the many blessings from God. How people use money could either be a blessing or a curse. Earn as much as you can, save as much as you can, and give as much as you can. Edward, take these coins and give them to Stacy, and please repeat after me. Stacy, take these coins.
Stacy, take these coins.
As a symbol of all that we shall share.
As a symbol of all that we shall share.
As husband and wife.
As husband and wife.
In Jesus' name, amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
This time of the marriage ceremony, Edward and Stacy would now like to share in the wedding candle. Symbolism is an integral part of the wedding ceremony. A symbol is the visible sign which points reality beyond the physical eye. Edward and Stacy have made promises to each other before God and in the presence of family and friends, and they have symbolized those promises by exchanging wedding rings. Edward and Stacy have a lighted candle which represents their individual lives. As Edward and Stacy light this wedding candle, they are representing the love and warmth that they will share in marriage. Each year, Edward and Stacy and this wedding candle will be lit on your wedding anniversary, and I'd like to remind this happy and joyous occasion to show love and warmth to all family and friends who enter into your home. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, out of all the human family, you have brought together Edward and Stacy and united them in marriage. Grant them the grace of faithfulness and true affection toward each other. May their love and oneness be patterned into the love which is slow to lose patience, looks for ways of being constructive, is not possessive, and knows no limit to its endurance and no end to its trust. And in the days ahead, always strengthen and guide Edward and Stacy, that the joys and blessings of this life may be an expectation of the life to come. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Pulitzer Prize winner novelist and playwright Jerome Wideman wrote, human beings do not obtain permanent possession of each other when they marry. All they obtain is the right to work at the job of holding on to each other. And with that in mind, Stacy, please hold Edward's hands, palms up, so you may see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and vibrant with love, that are holding yours on your wedding day, as he promises to love you all the days of his life. And these are the hands that will work alongside yours, as together you build your future, as you laugh and cry, and you just share innermost secrets and dreams. And these are the hands that will work long hours for you and your new family. And these are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. And these are the hands that will countlessly times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. And these are the hands that will tenderly lift your chin and brush your cheeks as they raise your face to look into his eyes, eyes that are filled completely with this overwhelming love and desire for you. And now, Edward, please hold Stacy's hands palms up so you may see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend, smooth, young, and carefree, that are holding yours on your wedding day as she pledges her loving commitment to you all the days of her life. And these are the hands that will hold your children in tender love, soothing them through illness and hurt, supporting and encouraging them along the way, and knowing when it is time to let go. And these are the hands that will hold you tight as you struggle through difficult times. And they are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years for a lifetime of happiness. And then these are the hands that will let you go to as many martial art workouts as you want to with the guys. Stacy, these are the hands that will give you his first paycheck so that you can go shopping for shoes. These are the hands that will give you support as she encourages you to chase down your dreams. And together as a team, everything you wish for can be realized. God bless you both. And for as much as Edward and Stacy have in this hour before God, family and friends pledge their love and faith to each other, see the vows on the giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce them husband and wife. Edward, you may kiss your beautiful bride.
groom, Thomas and Joanne Shaper.
Shepherd.
And now the parents of the groom, Noel Lucero and Maima Ruth Dillon. I introduce you to the people who stood witness to the couple as they took their vows. Primary sponsors, Glenn and Fallon Rodillon, Gil Lucero, and standing in for Julie Materia, Gemma Lucero. Next up, we got the pair that lit the path of the groom and bride, candle sponsors, Christopher Almario and Elisa Tantrahol. The pair that called the bride and groom, the veil sponsors, Jeremy DeGuzman and Christine Bagnell. The pair that bound the bride and groom together as one, court sponsors Gilbert Villafania and Angela Aguilar. I would also like to acknowledge the following people who have played significant roles during the ceremony. To the little hands that share their precious time with the couple, ring bearer Adam Shepherd and coin bearer Abigail Bagnell, and flower girl, Elizabeth Palmer. The best man and maids of honor who have been assisting the couple all day and in the months leading up to the wedding, Matthew Shepherd, Irene Nicole Lucero, and Jay Fernandez. Finally, please help me welcome, for the very first time, ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, I now present to you, Mr. Edward Shepherd and Mrs. Stacey Rodillon Shepherd. Gentlemen, we're going to have the maids of honor, one maid of honor, Jade Fernandez, and court sponsor, Angela Aguilar, sing the very first song. So here we go. And here's the first dance.
Forevermore, you
other world. I love you.
When Ed asked me to be his best man, I was not too surprised. After all, I've known him for quite some time. We were catching up on things leading up to the wedding, and, you know, sharing stories and all of that. And, you know, maybe at some point I would have been surprised. We were talking, and I told him, one of my fond memories was I used to run around following him, my, you know, older brother, pestering him with this doll. And I'd run around and just kind of shake it at him, I think. And he would get extremely annoyed. And eventually he'd do something to this doll. He'd throw it up in a tree and wouldn't be able to catch it. You know, weeks would go by and then there'd be a big storm and blow this thing down and get this big grin on my face. I'd pester my brother once again. So, of course, I'd get it, and we'd repeat this cycle. So I'm like, hey, Ed, do you remember this? And he goes, no, you pestered me so much that I don't remember that one little pestering thing. But like I said, I'm very honored, because my brother has taught me many things in life. He taught me how to tie my shoes. He taught me how to tie a tie. He taught me how to have a very classy drink. He made my first drink ever. Well, with this lovely wedding and reception and this beautiful bride that he's chosen, I think he's also taught me how to tie the knot properly. So, all the best, brother. And I'm just overwhelmed.
All right.
I actually have a poem here that I think it says everything that I wanted it to mean. Here it goes. I carry your heart with me. Here goes one. I carry your heart in my heart. Wherever, I am never without it. Anywhere I go, you go, my dear. And whatever is done by only me is your doing, my darling. I fear no fate for you. My one fate, my sweet. I want no world for beautiful you are. My world, my true. And it's you are whatever my moon has always meant, and whatever a sun will always sing is you. Here is the deepest secret nobody knows. Here is the root of the root, and the bud of the bud, and the sky of this, and the sky of the tree called life, which grows higher than the soul can hope or mind can hide. And this is the wonder that keeps the stars apart. I carry your heart in my heart. Oh, I okay, so I just like to conclude this by saying I'm so happy for both of you. I'm so excited for this next chapter in your life, and I hope that this time you guys will be settled in one place, less driving back and forth. And I love you, and with you by my side, and me in your life, I know that there is no battle we cannot fight together. I love you. That's it!
Let's hear from Nicole, guys. We also have maid of honor and best friend of the bride, Jay Fernandez.
That wasn't fair because she made me cry. He said, I am Stacey's best friend, I'm Jade. We've been friends since we were 13, and I have a cheat sheet. Our friendship has been about 20 years old now, and over the 20 years that we've been friends, you have become the closest thing I have to a sister, and I'm gonna cry. We were inseparable in high school. We followed each other to college, and when you moved to the Bay Area, I practically moved up with you, mostly because my two best friends were in the Bay Area and I wasn't about to start drinking by myself. needless to say, I know Stacey backwards and forwards and inside out, and if you know Stace, you know that there's no one else in the world quite like her. And while there are some people out there that are easy to love, Stacey most definitely is not one of those people. Loving Stacey takes a lot of work, and sometimes a lot of work. She's opinionated, she's controlling, she needs to have things just so, and she has to be right all the time.
Thank you.
And today, Ed has taken on the monumental task of loving this woman forever.
No returns next time.
But I think that he's discovered what I quickly discovered when I was in the eighth grade. And that is that the same stubborn, hard-headedness that can make her so difficult also makes her one of the best friends you could ever have. I'm gonna cry. She is stubbornly loyal, and she will fight to the death for you. And when she has chosen to love you, she will commit to that for the rest of her life. Whew. So, Ed, before I let Stacey become your problem now, I do want to share some words of wisdom that has been handed down to me from my mom and to Stacey. She always told me that love is a choice. And in marriage, it is a choice and a vow that you must make, not just today, but over and over again, at every anniversary, at the beginning of every day, at the end of every night. And on the hard days, you must remind yourself at minute intervals, but always, always, always choose to love each other above all. So tonight, we celebrate the commitment that Stacey and I have made to each other, to choose to love each other now and forever. And I'd like us to raise our glasses and toast to a lifetime of happiness and love for the bride and groom.
Thank you very much, Shay. And next up making the toast is the father of the groom, Mr. Thomas Shepard.
My lady wife, Joanne, and I are extremely happy and proud this evening. We've come to know Stacey over a period of time, and we admire her. She's intelligent, she's beautiful, and she has a core of steel. All together, it's a wonderful package. Recently, I've become to know her mother, so I think I know where some of that comes from. But like I said, we are very glad to have her. We're not just happy to have you as a daughter-in-law, we are delighted to have you as a daughter-in-law. Now, what can I say of my son, Seth? That's your name. It is said of some men, not all, some men, that they march to their own drummer. Ed is one of those men. Although from what you've seen on the floor, probably better to say that he dances to his own music. I would hope for the two of you to drink deep in life, as you two are uniquely capable of doing. You're special people, you can accomplish a great deal, and I hope that for you. I would also hope that you have long lives, happy lives, and a very productive marriage. But also, Ed and Stacey, may you both also always dance to your own music. Thank you.
Cheers, ladies and gentlemen. And last but not least, we have the mother of the bride, Myrna Rodillon.
Noelle and I would like to welcome you all today and thank everyone for coming to celebrate the wedding of my daughter Stacey and my brand new son-in-law, Ed. It's my pleasure to be here today to celebrate their wedding with family and friends. Stacey and Ed worked so hard on great details, on every detail of their wedding to honor their family and friends. I would like to take this opportunity to thank all the sponsors and that made this occasion a success. It is my honor to mention their names. Glenn and Fallon Rodillon, Gil Osero and Julie Miteria. I would also like to thank Gemma for standing as proxy for my sister Julie as one of the primary sponsors who is unable to make it on time. My father and my sister are coming to celebrate their union next month. A little late. You know, Filipinos, they're always late, but this one, they are really late. Nicole and Suzanne have worked so hard in helping Ed and Stacey in preparation of their wedding. Nicole and Suzanne, thank you very much for the wonderful success of Stacey's bridal shower and bachelorette party. The only regret, I was not invited at the bachelorette party. Matthew, I'm sure the bachelor's party was a blast. You did not invite me to. Secondary sponsors, Kendall, Dr. Chris Almario, and Alisa, thank you. Vale, Jeremy and Chrissy, thank you. Cord, Gil and Angela, thank you very much. Accept our gratitude for your participation in the success of this wedding. For Libby, the flower girl, Abigail, coin bearer, Adam, ring bearer, you guys did an amazing job. Thank you very much. Stacey, from the time I held you in my arms when you were born, I was overwhelmed with love for you. You are the daughter that every parent hopes to have, raise, and aspire to raise. You are the daughter that they wish to raise and have. I'm truly lucky and blessed to be your mother. Ed, we couldn't be more proud to be our son-in-law. We are honored to welcome you to our family. As Ed and Stacey begin their lives together, Noelle and I both feel that we are not losing a daughter, but entrusting her to Ed's good care. We feel that we gain a new son. I already told you that multiple times. Stacey has been a blessing to my life. Irwin, her biological father, who we lost from Stacey's early age from a tragic accident. Noelle, the father he grew up with and took care of her like his own. Nicole, the sister Stacey have loved and boss around. To this day, Nicole would say, "You are not the boss of me, or you're not my mom." However, there was one instance where Nicole called her mom. That's how bossy she is. Stacey, I know in your Lola's, I know in my heart that your Lola Rennie, my mom, your dad Irwin, and your Lola Efren are here in spirit, celebrating this special occasion in your life. Congratulations to both of you. Noelle and I would like to thank each and everyone for celebrating with us today as Stacey and Ed begin their lives together. Without further ado, I'd like everyone to raise your glass in honor of Stacey and Ed. Here is to many years of love and laughter ahead. Cheers.
Thank you very much, Maria. At this point, we would like to remind you guys to record a message to the bride and groom by locating the videographer. He's on the dance floor right now, handsome gentleman, who will be circulating around the room throughout the evening. He will take your comments that you want to record for the bride and groom, so make sure to track him down at some point in the night. Make sure you leave a nice message. And with that, my favorite part, dinner. Who's hungry?
Congratulations to both of you. In my favorite movie, Meet the Robinsons, one of the characters said, the woman is always right. So, Ed, the woman is always right. Congratulations. I wish you many years.
Ed, the woman is not always right. Compromise, okay?
Congratulations. Love you both.
Okay, Stacey and Ed, congratulations. And we hope you love each other every day of your life. Congratulations.
Where's Stacey? My name's Derek. I'm Jade's friend. And I just wanted to say congratulations. Thanks for letting me hang out and have a good time. And I just wanted to say how classy it was. I loved watching the first dance, having your friends sing. And you guys look very elegant out on the floor. And wish you all the best and a happy 2013. Thank you.
Hi, Stacey and Ed. Thanks for having us at your wedding. Thanks for all the mentorship. I don't know if that's a word. But thanks for being my mentor. And congrats on your marriage from the Harrises.
Congratulations, Stacey. I just wanted to wish you the best. I'm so honored to be part of this really special day and to be here. I mean, going way back from the time that we were about, well, you were 9 and I think I was 7, and it's just really awesome to see how happy you are, and I wish you the best, and I'm excited to see what's going to happen in the next chapter of your life, and I love you. Congratulations.
All right.
Stacey is one of my oldest friends in the world. I'm so excited for you and Ed, and we hope that you guys never take each other for granted and laugh a lot and enjoy many, many, many more happy days throughout your lives together.
Stacey and Ed, what a beautiful first dance. May they be the first of very many.
Hi, Stacey. Hi, Edward. I'm so honored that I get to witness your reunion, your marriage, and I would like to wish you well for a happy, long marriage. My little advice, always work out all your disagreements before you go to bed. Never go to sleep angry with each other, and everything will work out just fine. So good luck. We're here for you, and I'm so happy for you. Have a happy, happy married life. Love you.
Congratulations, Ed and Stacey. Ed and Stacey, congratulations. We're really excited for you guys. We're very happy that you guys are taking that next step. You know, we're newlyweds too, and we're in the same boat as you guys are, so we're learning along the way, but the only advice I can have is just really every day, you know, kiss your wife, Ed, every morning, and say I love you.
So
there we go.
That's it. You're so sweet.
Wow.
What he said.
Oh, that's, are we still on? Is this live?
Congratulations, Stacey.
Congratulations.
Stop. Stop. Don't care.
We're pushing for 3.
Then you should talk. Congratulations. Make sure you say I love you every day. Anybody else?
We agree.
Yeah.
Stacey, Ed, just want to congratulate you guys and wish you many years of happiness and joy.
I have notes.
Okay.
His emails. Oh my God.
Today, right. Come on.
I'm raising it first. Okay. Hey, I don't read it.
Stacey.
Thank you for hiring me.
Thank you for hiring me. You've always had an amazing reputation for guidance.
Is that who you have to blame for this?
And the one thing that I've always been able to have faith in is the fact that you helped guide me so that I'm a better person today than I could have been yesterday. And my hope for you is to have the same as you progress in your life and find and meet and get married to the person that you love and continue on until the very end when you are able to realize that everything that you've done in the past has made you and everyone that you've met the luckiest people in the world. Thank you very much.
Stacey and Ed, not just Stacey.
Okay.
Ed, congratulations.
Congratulations. You have the most amazing posture I have ever seen. Your ability to dance has always surprised me. And one thing that I really want to appreciate, and I really want you to appreciate,
I think it's not
you
listening to understand. Like 2 minutes ago. I'm starting already. This thing ends at 11.
It ends at, okay. Paraphrasing.
Thank you.
Oh, hello, testing. Hello, we are here. San Diego's in the house here, and we just want to congratulate both of you on a job well done. I know this was a lot of work, and wish you guys best of luck in your marriage, and we love you guys, and have fun. Oh, and make sure you pick up your socks, dude. All right? Okay.
All right, Ed and Stacey, have long, you know, healthy, happy lives together, and thanks for inviting me to this lovely wedding. And enjoy it, enjoy each other, enjoy the rest of your life.
Well, Ed and Stacey, I just got to say that was a marvelous dance. I wonder where you learned that stuff. That was just great. And whatever you do, keep dancing. Keep dancing. Best wishes to you.
Thank you, Martin.
Hi, Stacey and Ed. I am a man of few words, so to quote your father, Ed, I hope that your life is going to be productive.
Hi, Stacey and Ed. We just came from Houston this afternoon, so we wouldn't miss this lovely wedding of yours. And thank you very much for giving us the opportunity to participate in your wonderful and lovely wedding.
Congratulations! I hope you have a happy live after.
God bless you.
Now she got a turn.
Thank you. Congratulations, Ate Stacey. I wish you the best. I love you.
Congratulations, wish. Best wishes. I love you.
Hi, Ed and Stacey. I'm not sure how many years ago now, but we were at a family dinner, and our dad, always known for his tact, hinted broadly how much he would like Ed to propose to Stacey. And I remember thinking at the time, oh, he shouldn't have done that. Now Ed's going to have to wait an appropriate amount of time to prove that it was his idea and not Dad's. So Ed, I think you proved your point. And Stacey, you hung in there. Good job. Congratulations, both of you.
Okay.
All three of you.
Congratulations! Bye.
Hi, Ed and Stacey. Congratulations and have a happy marriage.
So, Ed and Stacey, first off, this guy is blinding me with this light here. It's horrible.
But other than that, it was a great wedding and everything. Ed, I used to be your youngest uncle. I don't know if that's true anymore. That's the chicken cordon bleu chucking me out behind you guys. So, have a great life. Love you.
This is a princess. This is really a princess. What? This is a princess. And I see it.
Stacey, everything is beautiful. You look amazing, and I have never seen you so happy. Ed, take good care of her. Congratulations, you two.
Yep.
Stacey, goodbye. Chris, thank you.
All right.
Hi, Ed, as well. We'd just like to say congratulations, and we made it.
I love wearing it.
You do.
Makes me feel sexy.
Yeah,
I sent you like 5 emails asking if you were sure that we both wear tuxes.
Don't listen to him. It was a great decision.
You said yes.
Yes. You could rent. You can buy really cheap. I bought really cheap.
No suits. No suits that we have.
We have very cheap suits.
I love wearing vests. I don't have vests. I love what I'm wearing today. I love this. This is true. Oh, I love this. Don't listen up. Good choice.
We love you. This is what we did for you.
Yes.
So, congratulations. I am.
We've done it regardless.
Yes. No, no. I'm a little Western. What we did for you. So, yes. We love you.
So, good luck. Congratulations, guys. Congratulations.
Congrats. Have a very fruitful marriage as a father. Father blessed.
Awesome, guys. Next up, we need one person to pull out their keys. Please pull out your keys.
Winner.
Awesome. And the last person is going to grab a napkin. Please, if you soil their napkin, please don't open it up. Awesome, guys. So what we're going to do is play musical chairs with these. We're going to pass these items over to our right-hand side, and we're going to keep speeding up as the song goes along, okay? When the music starts... Oh, I'm sorry. Ladies and gentlemen, everybody please rise out of your seats. Come out. Stand up. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we need to play this game standing up. Please rise out of your seats. Everybody get up. All right, guys, you ready?
Yes.
Here we go.
This car is automatic. It's systematic.
Are you guys ready? Pass it along to the right. Go faster. Faster, faster. All right, pass it to the window back. Pass it over your head. Under your leg. Faster, faster. Pass it below the other person's leg. All right, ladies and gentlemen, freeze. Alright, so if you are holding the napkin, congratulations, you win the picture frame! Next up, if you are holding the key, congratulations, you win the dancing figurine! holding up the dollar bill, if you have the dollar bill in your hand, please raise it really high. Really, really high. Ladies and gentlemen, if you were the person who pulled out that dollar bill, please raise your hand. Please give the dollar bill back. Now, if you're the person who's getting the dollar bill back, congratulations, you are the person who wins the floral centerpiece. It is your generosity that makes you a winner this whole time. Stacey and Edward, with Mr. Noel Lucero and Mrs. Joanne Shepard. Finish the dance with Noel Soul. Chance to show your moves. We're going to invite you guys up for a dance of bounty. If you guys have some cash, I've got deep pockets to fill. Wait, what is that, goggles? Ladies and gentlemen, Stacey is for the taking.
the way you look at me. Oh, that is for the only one I see. He is very, very extraordinary. He is even more than anyone that you adore can love. He's all that I can give to you.
Ha ha ha! Thank you. gives you an eye, a little more holds you tight. And you can smile, every smile for the man who held your hand very much. But don't forget who's taking you home and who's gonna be. So darling, save the last dance for me. Oh, I know that the music's playing like sparkling wine. Go ahead and have me come. Well, I've been saved, but when we are apart, don't give your heart to anyone. And don't forget who's taking you home and who's on to blame. So, oh darling, save the last dance for me. Baby, don't you know I love you so? Can't you feel it when we touch? I will never, never let you go. I love you oh so much. You can dance and go and carry on till the night is gone and it's time to go. If you're all alone, can't he walk you home? You must tell him no. Just don't forget who's taking you home.
Oh,
floor. No hands. I'm just kidding. Go for it. Planet Attack. That was a total surprise attack there. Congratulations, who unwittingly caught the ardor. Alright guys, dance. Get one of those pounds. Please come to the dance floor.